Hello everyone, welcome to another tutorial from Brilliant Bios. In this lecture, I will discuss isotype of antibody and their function. It is very important. So today's topic is isotype, or it is also called as class of antibody. In our body, there are five class of isotype. This is also called isotype or class, like Ig, G2. You can remember it as a gamed: IgG, IgA, IgM, IgE and IgD. So this is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So in our body there are five isotype or class of antibody. They perform different function and they differ in a particular region of antibody. So let's draw a structure of antibody. A antibody consists of two heavy chain and two light chain. This is heavy chain and this is light chain. Two heavy chain and two light chain. And each heavy and light chain is also divided into two separate domain. In the light chain, it is called variable light and constant light. In case of heavy chain, it is called variable heavy and constant heavy domain 1, constant heavy domain 2 and constant heavy domain 3 for G, IgG, IgA, IgE and IgD. These four antibody represent three constant heavy domain. But IgM antibody contain another constant heavy domain called CH4. You can remember it. Okay. And the main important point I want to mention: all the isotype of antibody, they differ only in the constant heavy domain in this region, only in this chain. They do not differ in this region or in the constant light chain or the variable chain. This region is called variable and this region is called constant. So on the isotype differ in the constant heavy chain domain. So for your better understand, I want to give you an example. Let's assume there is two B cell. One is B1 and another B cell, that is B2. Let's assume these two B cells, and they also express B cell receptor, means IgM and IgD, in their membrane bound condition. So a B cell, when it is naive in condition, it means when it has not recognized any antigen or pathogen, it is called naive. So a naive B cell, this is also a naive B cell, express IgM and IgD as their B cell receptor. Okay. So at first, a B cell express IgM and IgD, that is membrane bound in condition, called B cell receptor. This B cell receptor can recognize antigen. So let's draw antigen. So if this B1 cell can recognize a bacteria, and if this B2 cell recognize a helminth, so this is a bacteria and this is a helminth. So if this B1 cell is recognizing a bacteria and this B2 cell recognizing a helminth, then one thing occur. This is called class switching or isotype switching. This B1 cell, when it gets attached with the bacteria, it becomes activated and it becomes plasma cells. This B2 cell, when bind with helminth, it also become activated, called plasma cell. This plasma cell can secrete antibody. So B1 cell cannot secrete it when it is naive in condition. The B2 cell also cannot secrete antibody when it is naive in condition. But when it become activated or attached with the antigen, it may be from the bacteria or helminth, now it becomes activated, become effector cells called plasma cells that can secrete antibody. So now these two cells can secrete antibody. And depending on the type of pathogen, like here it is bacteria and here it is helminth, depending on the type of pathogen, the plasma cell starts to secrete a particular type of antibody that can actually eliminate the pathogen. In case of bacteria, the plasma cell can secrete IgM or IgG antibody. Here is another I want to mention that not only isotype, there are sub isotype also present, like IgG1, IgG2, there is in human IgG1 to 4, this subtype also present. So let's assume the B1 cell is producing these three antibody, because this all isotype have different functions. Like this IgG perform one thing called opsonization. I have make a separate video on opsonization. Another thing it can perform called ADCC, antibody dependent cell mediated cytotoxicity. Opsonization means when this IgG coat a bacteria, this bacteria when is coated by IgG molecule or antibody, this bacteria can be engulfed or phagocytosed very efficiently. So IgG actually helps to eliminate bacteria. So opsonization, and I can write it as a bacteria. So when a B1 cell senses that it is a bacteria, the plasma cell secrete IgG or its subtypes, because this IgG can opsonize. Okay, and also another thing is it can activate complement pathway. It is very important. By complement pathway, one bacteria can be destroyed, because the ultimate result of the complement pathway is the formation of a complex called MAC that can actually form a pore-like structure, MAC, MAC, membrane attack complex. The ultimate result of the complement pathway is the production of a complex called MAC, MAC, that is actually membrane attack complex, that attack the membrane of the bacteria and kill the bacteria. So IgG can destroy or kill bacteria. So the B1 cell senses that there is bacteria, so it will produce a plasma cell that can actually, so it will produce a plasma cell that can secrete IgG type of antibody. So this is the role of IgG. It will not secrete, this plasma cell will not secrete IgE, because the function of IgG is to eliminate helminth. This IgG, IgE do not perform opsonization, do not perform ADCC, and do not perform complement pathway. It cannot destroy, IgE antibody cannot destroy bacteria. It can only destroy helminth. So if I ask you, this plasma cell, what type of antibody it will produce? The answer is only IgE antibody. All the antibody will be IgE, because IgE antibody can eliminate this helminth. So one important thing is, now if I ask you, at first the antibody was IgM and IgD. Now this antibody becomes IgG, IgM or other subtype of IgG. So the antibody has changed its isotype into another antibody. It was IgM or IgD. Now it has become IgG. This is called class switching. Is there any difference in the binding of the antigen? I want to mention that this IgM and IgD can recognize the bacterial antigen. Now after changing the class, like from IgM to IgD, this is called class switching. So after changing the class, is there any changes in the antigen binding capability? No. The IgG can also recognize the same bacteria. I am mentioning you the same bacteria, because during the procedure of class switching or isotype changing, the antigen binding ability or the antigen binding site of the antibody will not change. It will remain same. Only the constant region, this constant region will change. So let me draw a picture. Let's assume the B1 cells, at first it is expressing IgM that looks like this, and it consists of variable light, constant light, variable heavy, constant heavy 1, constant heavy 2, constant heavy 3 and constant heavy 4. This B1 cell, it is showing the IgM as a B cell receptor. It's but when the IgM is changed into IgG by class switching, the antibody looks like this. Now you could understand the binding site. This is called binding site. This variable region is called FAB region, means antigen binding fragment of antigen binding. This will remain the same. This region will remain the same, FAB region. And also the light chain, there is no change in the light constant, change of the light chain. Only you can see the change is happening in this region, that is called the FC or constant heavy domain. So if I draw the bacteria, if this antibody can recognize the bacteria, now after becoming the IgG, this IgM actually changing its isotype into IgG, it also can recognize the same bacteria. So after changing the isotype, it will not change the antigenic binding region of the antibody. So all the isotype actually differ in the constant heavy domain of antibody, not in the variable region, variable domain of antibody, or the constant light domain of antibody. You have to remember this. This is very important. You have to remember this. Also, you can see that the IgM can be changed into IgE. This IgE during bacterial infection, IgG can be produced, and during helminth infection, IgE can be produced. Then also, when the IgM become IgE, only this region will be changed. This region, the CH domain will change, not the variable region or the constant light region. So this is all about concept of isotype of antibody. Now let me draw the gene. In our gene, this all the isotype and the sub-isotype of antibody are encoded in different gene segments. In human, there is 9 these gene segment. This type of gene are present. So if I write this, in human, I am mentioning the human gene. In case of mice, there is different gene segment. In human, for the IgG, there are gamma 1 gene segment, gamma 2 gene segment, gamma 3, gamma 4, alpha 1 and alpha 2. So now you can see, from this gamma 1 gene segment, IgG1 will produce. From this gamma 2, IgG2 will be produced. From this gamma 3, IgG3 and IgG4 will produce. This is the sub-isotype or subclass of antibody. You have to remember this. The subclass or sub-isotype of antibody. And alpha 1, it will produce IgA1, alpha 2, IgA2. This is also the subclass. And there should be delta, epsilon and mu. From this delta, it will produce IgD. From this epsilon, it will produce IgE. And this from mu, it will produce IgM. So these are all encoded in our genome, in a different gene segment. These genes are present. When the B cell is naive in condition, it activates these two gene segment. One is IgD segment, delta segment and mu segment, for the production of IgD and IgM. These are the B cell receptor. You have to remember this. But if there is any bacterial infection, the B cell, same B cell, can activate this 4 segment of gene to produce IgG type of antibody, because IgG can eliminate or kill bacteria by opsonization complement pathway. And if there is any infection in the mucosal tissue, mucosal area, like in our intestine or respiratory tract or urogenital tract, these two antibody will be produced. It is called IgA. Okay, so this is called isotype switching, and these are the gene segment. One B cell can activate this gene segment according to the presence of or different type of pathogen. Okay, now let's know the function of each and every isotype of antibody. So, like IgA, it provides mucosal immunity. Like in the milk as a secretion, it is mucosal tissue. So it IgA is present in the milk. In the respiratory tract, in the intestine, if there is an infection, mucosal immunity as provided by IgA antibody. Okay, then IgE, as I have already mentioned, IgE is responsible for helminth immunity, against the helminth. And also IG develop a disease condition called type 1 hypersensitivity, simply means allergy. For the development of allergy, IG is responsible. Those people who are atopic in nature, atopic means in our normal healthy individual, IG antibody is not produced. But some people, those who are atopic, means allergy prone human being, they produce IgE in normal conditions. So IgE can actually build against helminth immunity, or it can produce type 1 hypersensitivity. It's a disease condition. IgG, as I have mentioned, can perform ADCC, antibody dependent cell mediated cytotoxicity. In my another video, I have made separate video on ADCC and opsonization to kill the bacteria by phagocytosis. Opsonization help in phagocytosis so that it can kill the bacteria, and it can activate complement pathway. And the function of IgM is to form the B cell receptor, and it can also activate the complement pathway. IgM can also activate complement pathway. And the role of IgD is, in its soluble nature it is not known, but when it is bound, membrane bound condition, it helps in B cell receptor. So these five, IgA, IgE, IgG, IgM and IgD, perform these functions mainly. Hope this video will help you. If you like my video, please subscribe and share this video with your friends. And if you have any doubts, write me in the comment section. Thank you for watching, and always keep learning.